guys, it's Grandpa.
And Emily.
Welcome back to Country Double Play.
Where we take one song by two different artists, and then Emily reacts to it, and I just get to listen to the music I like.
And apparently some, well...
She found out that I have a very eclectic taste in music. everywhere from ZZ Top to Frank Sinatra to Queen. Big Band to Queen.
Beatles.
Beatles, and the Monkees.
Whatever that
Elvis.
Is.
Elvis. You don't know the Monkees.
No.
Going to have to just
I think
educate
there's a band
you.
Called Arctic Monkees or something.
No.
Not them?
No.
You know who I'm talking about? Is
no.
that a band?
I don't know. Okay, so what are we doing tonight?
I Don't Want to Miss a Thing by Aerosmith and Mark Chestnut.
Okay, so let's go ahead and get into it and get you guys some information. Okay, I Don't Want to Miss a Thing by Aerosmith and Mark Chestnut. I Don't Want to Miss a Thing is a rock ballad performed by American hard rock band Aerosmith for the 1998 natural disaster film Armageddon, which lead singer Steven Tyler's daughter Liv Tyler starred in. It is one of four songs performed by the band for the film. Written by Diane Warren, the song debuted at number one on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100, giving the band their first and only number one single there. The song stayed at number one for 4 weeks, from September 5th to September 26th, 1998. The song was nominated for both an Academy Award for the Best Original Song and a Golden Raspberry Award for the Worst Original Song. I Don't Want to Miss a Thing is the eighth studio album released by American country music artist Mark Chestnut, his last album for Decca record label. I Don't Want to Miss a Thing produced two singles on the Billboard Hot Country Song charts, including a cover of Aerosmith's song by the same name, which reached number one on the country charts, becoming the final number one of his career thus far. The cover was also Chestnut's biggest crossover, reaching number 20 on the Billboard Hot 100. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. And we'll do Aerosmith first, since they sang it first.
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
Spend with
Okay, and now Mark Chestnut.
I could stay awake just to hear you breathing, watch you smile while you're sleeping, while you're far away and dreaming. I could spend my life in this sweet surrender. I could stay lost in this moment forever. Close to you, feeling your heart beating, and I'm wondering what you're dreaming, wondering if it's me you're seeing. Then I kiss your eyes and thank God we're together. I just wanna stay with you in this moment for.
What'd you think of that?
I liked Aerosmith's version better. I mean, they were both good. I think the song can swing both ways.
Yeah. Though. Yeah, that's I didn't think it was much of a reach for that song to go country. It actually probably could have been a country song. I don't know that you'd have known the difference.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like if I never had heard of that song and didn't know who it was by, I'd probably think it was like a country artist.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe. Yeah. No, I agree. I think he did a really good job on it, Mark Chestnut. Would you say it's a completely different song? No, I just say just sung different, huh?
They weren't even really sung differently from each other.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, I mean, just a little
Tyler
bit.
Tyler gets a little rocky in the end with that little bit of screaming thing
that
he does.
That just doesn't even, like, sound like him either. Like, see.
I think because it's a ballad and you're so used to his hard rock stuff that.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. Like, it was weird. Like, I feel like it's someone, like, from, I can't think of the band, but.
Probably, like, Poison or something. And,
yeah. Yeah, something like that.
Because they've got a couple mellow rock songs. So anyway, that's it for this week. Sorry we missed last week. That was on me. We thought we didn't have anything to do, and we was wrong. And so, and Thursday was the only night I could do it, of course. It was one of those things. So anyway, we're back on track. And again, don't forget to
like and subscribe and hit the post notification bell to get notified every time we post a new video.
Yeah.
And comment.
Yes. our Elvis song got huge hits. Like, I think we're at 360 views and, I don't know, 10, 15, 20 comments. The last song had 3 views, and I think 2 of them were me checking it out. So, anyway. We hope you liked what we did tonight. I've got some more, a little bit on this side, not quite such a big genre change. There's a lot of bands out there like, Marshall Tucker, you might've seen Mark Chestnut's heard it in a love song, on the titles, and you know, they're more of a, I'm going to say a country rock band, but, have some of that and some other bands that weren't necessarily country bands that there are some country covers for, and we'll be getting to those. I kind of said when this channel started, if you didn't start listening to country music until the 70s or 80s, you may not know any of these songs. I'm probably going to reach back and pull up an oldie for next week. I don't know what yet, but I got a big list, but... We'll find something that she has never heard before, probably.
Oh.
Which hasn't been that hard so far. So anyway.
I've only known 2 of them.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. No. Yeah. Tennessee Whiskey and I Will Always Love You.
Yeah.
I think are the only 2 I've known.
So anyway, hey, you guys have a great week, and we will see you next week. Bye.
If he doesn't make plans. Peace out, Girl Scout.
She meant bye.
That was weird. I don't ever want to do that again. Oh, boy. Just end it now.